In this video, we'll be looking at the most important Google Analytics e-commerce metrics and KPIs that you should be tracking. So let's get started. By tracking your metrics and key performance indicators, you can see where to improve your site and how to boost your revenue. If you're a WordPress user, there's a quick and easy way to enable e-commerce tracking in GA4. All you have to do is install and activate the Monster Insights plugin and then enable the Monster Insights e-commerce add-on. You won't even have to touch a line of code. If you'd like to learn more, just visit the link in the description to our guide on enabling e-commerce tracking in Google Analytics. Now let's look at the metrics to track in GA4. Your e-commerce revenue reflects the health of your store, so you'll want to keep an eye on it to watch for trends. To find the e-commerce revenue report, just go to Reports, then to Lifecycle, then to Monetization, and finally to Overview. If you're using Monster Insights, all you have to do is navigate to your admin sidebar, then to Reports, and then to the e-commerce tab. Now, once you're there, you'll see the revenue at the top of the report. One of the best ways to increase the revenue from your store is to encourage customers to spend more when they make a purchase. So you'll need to pay attention to tracking and improve your average order value. You can find this metric at the top of your Monster Insights report. The higher the average order value, the more income your store gets from each order. You can find this metric in GA4, but GA4 calls it average purchase revenue. To find your average purchase revenue, head to Reports, then to Monetization, then to Overview. Now scroll down to the graph that shows average purchase revenue per user. Since this report isn't that helpful, you want to create a custom report. To see your average purchase revenue metrics in GA4, you'll need to build a custom exploration report. Now, to create a custom report, you'll need to go to your analytics account, then go to the Explore tab. Once the page loads, you'll need to start a new custom exploration report by clicking on the blank template. Next, give your report a name. Now, you'll need to select and import your dimensions. To import dimensions, just click the plus button next to Dimensions, and then either use the search function or the drop-down menu and click on the box next to each dimension to select it. So for this report, we're going to be choosing device category, session source medium, city, and session campaign. Now, once you've chosen all of the dimensions, just click the import button at the top right. Next, you'll need to select and import your metrics. So you'll choose them just like you did the dimensions. So for this report, we'll just be selecting average purchase revenue. Be sure to click the import button at the top right. Now drag session source medium from dimensions into the rows box. And then drag average purchase revenue into your values box. Now you should have a report of your average purchase revenue by source medium. You can also move things around using the other dimensions that we imported. And that's going to allow you to see your average purchase revenue by city, by device category, or campaign. Now let's look at three ways that you can increase your store's average order value. One easy way to do this is to suggest your most popular products to your readers. Monster Insights makes this easy with its popular post feature. You can set it up by going to Insights, then to Popular Posts, and then to Popular Products. Another way you can do this is upselling. Upselling is persuading your customers to buy more products or something more expensive. Best Buy is an example of how to upsell products. When you add a product to your cart that has a protection plan, you'll see the offer when choosing your product options. And then during checkout, they offer their setup services as additional add-ons. And you can also offer free shipping at a certain amount like Old Navy does. All right, now let's look at shopping cart abandonment. On average, about 76% of people abandon their carts before completing the sale. To view your shopping cart abandonment rate in GA4, you'll need to set up a custom Explore report. So to do that, just start with a blank report in GA4, just like you did a moment ago. Next, give the report a name, like Shopping Funnel. Then select the Funnel Exploration option in the Technique box. Next, click on the pencil icon by steps. So for the name step one, view item and choose view item as the condition. For name step two, add to cart and choose add to cart as the condition. And in name step three, purchase and choose purchase as the condition. Here's what you should have now. Finally, click the blue apply button in the upper right to see the shopping funnel report that you just created, and you'll see the abandonment rate right here in your report. There are several reasons customers abandon their carts. For example, they may see unexpected costs at checkout, such as high shipping rates, or they may see that shipping is slow, or that your site doesn't have security badges or trust seals, or it might be that your form is too long or they're forced to create an account. So to reduce your cart abandonment rate, just read our article on how you can reduce shopping cart abandonment. I'll leave a link in the description. According to an Unbounce study, 70% of consumers say that a website's speed influences how likely they are to buy or how likely they are to return to the website again later. Plus, because of Google's page experience update, sites that load faster get bumped up in the search results pages. But you won't find a site speed report in GA4. It's in Google Search Console. But with Monster Insights, you can see your speed report in the WordPress dashboard. Plus, you can also see site speed metrics along with the tips for how to improve them. If you're running Google Ads, you need to know if you're generating more revenue than what you're spending in advertising. Now, you can create a custom report in GA4 to see those specific numbers. First, you'll need to start with a blank report. Now, for the dimensions, you'll need to add the Google Ads campaign. Next, in the metrics box, add purchases, Google Ads cost, Google Ads cost per click, and e-commerce revenue. Then drag the dimensions into the rows box and drag all those metrics into the values box. Now you should have a report that allows you to see how much each ad campaign costs and how much revenue it's bringing in. Now, if you'd like to improve your ad spend, you can try disabling or improving your low-performing ad campaigns. You could start running more ads for higher-cost products, or you could refine your keyword targeting and use geo-targeting where it's relevant. Or you might even want to try optimizing your landing pages and site user-friendliness. The customer lifetime value is the total amount that an average customer might spend at your store during their lifetime. Now, by calculating your customer's lifetime value, you can decide how much to spend on marketing. To find the lifetime value report in GA4, use their built-in User Lifetime Explorer report. To access it, just head to your Explore tab. Once you're there, scroll to the right to find User Lifetime. Now just click that and you'll see the report. Note that the report is broken down by first user medium. Now you can try using the other dimensions by dragging them over into the rows box and removing the ones that's there. Now, knowing the average customer lifetime value will help you decide how much to spend to bring new customers to your site and keep them coming back. Growing an email list helps you stay connected with your customers and leads, and that's going to help you drive repeat sales and improves your onboarding experience. So tracking additions to your email list is important. For WordPress users, the Monster Insights Forms add-on is the easiest way to track form submissions. The add-on tracks form submissions automatically. You don't have to go through any setup in Google Analytics or Tag Manager to track your forms. To see your form data, go to Insights, then to Reports, and then open the Forms tab. Once you're there, you'll see the impressions, conversions, and conversions rates for each form. If you want to try to track your form submissions without using Monster Insights, your best bet is to follow this form tracking tutorial. I'll leave a link in the description. You can find out how much revenue you're making from each source in your Monster Insights e-commerce report. If you'd like to view your Google Analytics e-commerce sales and revenue data organized by channel, then you'll need to navigate to Acquisition, then to Traffic Acquisition, then scroll to the right in the table to find Conversions and Total Revenue. Next, click the All Events drop-down arrow under Conversions and then select Purchase. Now the table shows the total purchases and revenue by traffic channel. Now to find out how users make it to checkout, if they're checking out on their first visit through a referral link, or if they found you through a search and then they come back using a direct channel to make a purchase, you can find out in your top conversion paths report. To see that report, navigate to the Advertising tab. Then Attribution and Conversion Paths. I'll leave a link in the description on how you can use that report. Having a retention strategy in place gives you a better chance of persuading your first-time buyers to make repeat purchases. If you want to know what your cart abandonment metrics look like for new and returning visitors, you can see that data in GA4. You'll need to go back to the funnel report that you created in the shopping cart abandonment section. Then add the dimension new established. Next, drag that dimension into the breakdown box. Now you can see the metrics for established returning users and new users. All right, once you create all the exploration reports that we've covered in this video, you'll have access to them whenever you like. You won't have to recreate them again, but it still takes time to log into GA4 and look at even the basic reports. With Monster Insights, you can see the most critical data on your WordPress dashboard. Plus, since Monster Insights makes setting up e-commerce reporting and viewing your top e-commerce metrics and KPIs so easy, like your conversion rate, revenue, top products, average order value, and add removal carts and more, it just makes sense to use Monster Insights. There you have it, the top 9 e-commerce metrics and KPIs to track in GA4. With Monster Insights, you get the website stats that matter. See why over 3 million websites use us. If you're not already using Monster Insights, you'll find a discount link in the description. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this. We'll see you next time.